Hello friends! Welcome! Today we will see how three-phase AC power is generated. Let's understand it step by step. First, what is AC power? It is an alternating current power. Alternating means current flows in forward and reverse directions alternatively through the conductor. If the power frequency is 50 Hz, then the current alters its direction 100 times. Hence, alternating current flows 50 times in one direction and 50 times in the opposite direction in 1 second for 50 Hz power supply, and 120 times for 60 Hz power supply. This is how the alternating current flows. Now let's understand how single-phase power is generated. A magnetic field is created in the generator using DC power. DC supply is given to the field windings of the generator, forming the north and south poles. This field winding is mounted in the rotor of the generator. We know that when a conductor is moved in a magnetic field, an EMF is generated in that conductor. Similarly, when a conductor is placed in a moving magnetic field, an EMF is generated in that conductor. In the case of generators, since field winding is mounted on the rotor, the magnetic field is rotating, and conductors in which EMF is generated are stationary. This generated EMF causes current to flow in the conductors. Now let's see the nature of this current. The direction and the magnitude of the current vary with the position of the coil with respect to the poles. Now let's see a single rotation of the rotor and the respective current behavior in a single phase generator. When rotor-mounted field winding rotates, EMF gets generated in the conductors. This EMF causes current to flow through these conductors. When concentrated magnetic lines of force, that is the magnetic field, are cut across by these conductors, the current value reaches its peak, which means electron speed is maximum through the conductors. And when a relatively weaker part of the magnetic field starts to cut across these conductors, current value starts decreasing and eventually falls to zero. It means the electron speed through the conductors decreases. Similarly, the current reaches its peak value on the negative side, when another part of the magnetic field is cut across by the conductors. This means the speed of electrons reaches its maximum value but in opposite direction through the conductors. This is how alternating current is sinusoidal in nature. Hence the speed of the electron starts from zero, reaches the maximum, again reaches zero, and then again reaches the maximum in opposite direction, and reaches zero. This happens in one complete rotation of the field winding. This one rotation of the rotor field winding is called one cycle. This rotor field winding rotates 50 times in 1 second, for 50 Hz frequency. And 60 times in 1 second for 60 Hz frequency. Hence the number of cycles of the rotor per second is called the frequency of power supply. Now, let's see how three-phase power is generated. The phase difference is achieved by the physical spacing between the poles of the generator. The phase difference is nothing but the distance between phases. This distance causes a time difference between peak values of the power, which in turn causes the phase difference. As we know, this complete peripheral distance is 360 degrees. This 360 degree is angular distance. If we accommodate three coils at an equal distance, each coil gets set at 120 degrees apart from the other coils. This is nothing but the phase difference between the phases. This peripheral distance is the cause of this time difference between these two peaks of the three-phase current. Now let's see another interesting fact about three-phase power. Vector addition of the current of all the three phases at any given instant is zero. For example, at a 90-degree instant. The value of one of the phases' current is x units, while the value of the other two phases' current is minus half x and minus half x, respectively. The addition of all three phases' current, which is x units, and twice of minus half x units is zero. Hence, in a balanced three-phase system, the current through neutral is zero. Another question may arise: if we can generate three-phase power just by using additional windings in the generator, then why not produce six-phase or 12-phase power? As we know, we have three-pole circuit breakers, three-conductors transmission line, three-phase transformer, and all the other equipment suitable for a three-phase power system. These three-phase power installations increase the complexity and cost of the system compared to the single-phase power system. And this complexity and cost of power installations increase very drastically for more than three phases, that is 6 phases or 12 phases. Hence, after thorough study and analysis, it is found that only a three-phase system offers an optimally complex and economic solution. Similarly, using less number of phases for power, that is 2 phases or a single phase, is not desirable. So guys, this is about three-phase power system. Hope you liked the video. If yes, please press the like button. For more videos, please subscribe and press the bell icon. Thank you.